Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Mahatma Gandhi's 150th birth anniversary year celebrations launched, addressing the international convention. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says, along with sanitation, government also emphasizing nutrition, underscores role of 4 P's, political leadership, public funding, partnerships and people's participation for success of the Swachh Bharat mission. First assembly of the International Solar Alliance inaugurated in Delhi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi calls for global efforts to harness solar power and bring down cost of production. Impossible to build a multipolar world without India, says United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres. Calls India important partner in countering terrorism and extremism, praises role in leading the fight against climate change. Chief Minister's panel to look into farmers' demands. Minister of State for Agriculture Gajendra Singh Shekhawat tells protesters government is looking into possibility of linking MNREGA with agriculture. Farmers reject assurance. And Nobel Prize in Physics shared by a woman after 55 years. Canadian physicist Donna Strickland awarded the prize jointly with Gerard Moreau from France and American Arthur Ashkin for their work in laser physics. At 96 years, Ashkin is the oldest Nobel laureate. Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary this year signals the start of a year-long celebration ahead of his 150th birth anniversary in 2019. On Tuesday, an inter-religious prayer meet was held at Gandhi Samadhi in Rajghat. President, Vice President, Prime Minister and other dignitaries attended the prayer meeting.
On the fourth anniversary of the Swachh Bharat mission, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has given the mantra of 4 P's for a cleaner world. He said that political leadership, public funding, people's participation and partnerships is the need of the hour for a cleaner world. The Prime Minister was addressing the concluding session of the Mahatma Gandhi International Sanitation Convention.
4 days after this summit, we all इस निष्कर्ष पर पहुंचे हैं कि विश्व को स्वच्छ बनाने के लिए 4 P आवश्यक है और ये 4 P का हमारा मंत्र है पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप पब्लिक फंडिंग पार्टनरशिप पीपल्स पार्टिसिपेशन दिल्ली डिक्लेरेशन के माध्यम से आप लोगों ने सर्वव्यापी स्वच्छता में इन 4 महत्वपूर्ण मंत्रों को मान्यता दी है इसके लिए मैं आप सभी का आभार व्यक्त करता हूं
UN Chief Antonio Guterres also said a clean India would be a befitting tribute to Mahatma Gandhi. The UN Chief also congratulated Prime Minister Modi for giving priority to sanitation. He hailed India as an example of how political will and commitment can help achieve safe sanitation. 53 ministers of sanitation from around the world and more than 160 international representatives from 68 countries participated in the 4-day convention.
May I congratulate you, Prime Minister, on your remarkable leadership and vision on this area that is vital for the well-being of humankind. And to begin marking the 150th birthday of Mahatma Gandhi by honoring this long record of advocacy and action on this vital issue is a fitting tribute to this great human being, an example for all of us. The Mahatma was ahead of his time when it came to safe, hygienic sanitation, as he was in so many other areas. He demanded the right of sanitation for everyone, and he demanded respect for that right from everyone. And the Clean India mission builds on his genius and lifelong quest for human dignity.
The nation paid homage to Mahatma Gandhi on his 149th birth anniversary on Tuesday. President Ramnath Kovind, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu, Prime Minister Narendra Modi offered floral tributes at Rajghat. The UN chief also paid tributes to the father of the nation. A Sarvadharma Prarthana Sabha was organized at Rajghat on this occasion. The UN General Assembly had on June 17, 2007 voted to establish 2nd October as the International Day of Nonviolence. In a message, the UN chief said, at a time of protracted conflicts and complex challenges, Gandhiji's philosophy of nonviolence remains an inspiration. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Information and Broadcasting Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore inaugurated a week-long multimedia exhibition in New Delhi on Tuesday. The exhibition begins celebrations of 150th birth anniversary year of Mahatma Gandhi. The interactive multimedia exhibition showcases the life and ideologies of Mahatma Gandhi. Rathore said that new technologies used in this exhibition have brought the life of Mahatma Gandhi closer to the people. The INB minister also released 11 books on the life of Mahatma Gandhi at the event. The nation is also marking the birth anniversary of former Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri. President Ramnath Kovind paid tributes to him, saying his integrity, wartime leadership and role in the shaping of the Green Revolution remains an inspiration for the entire country. And Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu also remembered the great son of the soil, Lal Bahadur Shastri. He also said that Shastri gave India a courageous leadership. He said his vision and commitment to develop the poorest of the poor is commendable. The Vice President also shared an article he wrote stressing on why Lal Bahadur Shastri matters in today's time. Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his tributes hailed his able leadership.
लाल बहादुर शास्त्री जी की यह विशेषता थी कि बाहर से वे अत्यधिक विनम्र दिखते थे परंतु भीतर से चट्टान की तरह दृढ़ निश्चयी थे। जय जवान जय किसान का उनका नारा उनके इसी विराट व्यक्तित्व की पहचान है। राष्ट्र के प्रति उनकी निस्वार्थ तपस्या का ही प्रतिफल था कि लगभग 1.5 वर्ष के संक्षिप्त कार्यकाल में देश के जवानों और किसानों को सफलता के शिखर पर पहुंचने का मंत्र दे गए।
And as the nation celebrates the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, artists from 124 countries have come together to pay homage to Bapu through a rendition of his favorite bhajan. A shorter medley version with artists from 40 countries was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the closing ceremony of Mahatma Gandhi International Sanitation Conference. We leave you with this as we slip into a very short break.
सकल लोक मान सहुने वंदे
सकल लोक मान सहुने वंदे निंदा ना करे के नीरे
काच मनानी चल राखे धन धन जनानी देनी रे
वैष्णव जनता थे न कहिए जे पीर पराई जाने रे
वैष्णव
उपकारे थारे दोए मन अभिमान अंगाने रे
सकल लोकमा सहुणे वंदे
निंदा न करे केनी रे
जीवाथकीय सत्य न बोले वर्धन नव ज्वले हाथ रे
वैष्णव जन तो तीने कहिए जे पीर पराई जाने रे
वैष्णव जन तो तीने कहिए जे पीर पराई
वैष्णव जन तो
Welcome back. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that India is aiming to make use of solar and wind energy to meet its energy requirements. Speaking at the first assembly of the International Solar Alliance, the Prime Minister said, India is targeting 40% electricity generation from non-fossil fuel-based resources by 2030. He said solar power will play the same role that oil wells have played over the past few decades in meeting global energy needs. Stating that the focus must be on renewable sources of meeting energy needs, he said India wants to bring all UN members on board of ISA. The Prime Minister said that a 121 country international solar alliance is the future OPEC for meeting energy needs of the world.
दुनिया की ऊर्जा आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति के लिए जो भूमिका आज ओपेक निभा रहा है वही भूमिका आने वाले समय में इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस आइसा की होने वाली है जो लोग आज तेल के कुओं का है वही रोल भविष्य में सूर्य की किरणों का होने वाला है
United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres has said that it is impossible to build a multipolar world without a very relevant role for India. On a three-day visit to India, the UN chief held talks with Prime Minister Narendra Modi and discussed issues of international concern.
United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres held talks with Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi on Tuesday. The two leaders discussed a wide range of international issues, including reforms in the UN Security Council and issues related to climate change, the World Trade Organization and terrorism. Interacting with students and the media after the talks, the UN chief said there is no place for religious intolerance in India.
I don't think India is in the worst situation in the world, so I've always seen India as a country with extreme diversity. I've always seen India as a country that is very welcoming for people coming from the outside, namely refugees, migrants. I've only seen India a country where there is a lot of respect for different people. But of course, in India, there are forms of extremism, as in any other part of the world. I don't think this is the major problem that you face. My wife was born in Goa. And when I go to Goa, it's quite amazing to see, in the same village, there is an Hindu temple, there is a Catholic church, and there is perfect inter-religious harmony. So I think that is the prevailing tradition in India.
Denouncing terrorism as a plague that affects the world, Guterres said that the United Nations is keeping an eye on the developments. He said that the organization is unable to take harsh action against terrorism as member nations have not come to an agreement regarding the definition of terrorism. Expressing caution on the Rohingya issue, Guterres stressed on the need for a solution soon before the refugee crisis could give rise to terrorism. On the issue of reforms in the UN Security Council, Guterres said that the key to reforms lies in the hands of permanent members of the Council.
Secretary General was abundantly clear that five permanent members of UN Security Council are still not ready for any reform. In that case, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj was quite right that UN may be irrelevant, as had been the fate of League of Nations. Akhilesh Soman for Rajya Sabha Television with camera person Anirban in Delhi.
On to some more developments, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu inaugurated a Dome Prayer Hall Library and the World Parliament of Science, Religion and Philosophy at MIT Pune on Tuesday. Addressing the gathering, he said that the entire world community should come together to fight terrorism. The Vice President also stressed on the need to make the education system relevant to the job market. He pointed that education was not meant only for employment, but also for enhancement of knowledge, empowerment and enlightenment.
Reinforcing the old idea of Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu, Vasudhaika Kutumbakam, the entire world is one. That is the philosophy behind this dome. And then why dome? To prevent the doom. You have to understand in a simple language. Because the way the world and the humanity is moving, and certain actions, certain happenings, certain tendencies which are very dangerous, divisive, discriminatory, violent, terror, and other problems that are coming up before the world. The answer lies in this.
Thousands of protesting farmers were stopped from entering Delhi today. Police resorted to water cannons and tear gas shells to disperse members of the Bharatiya Kisan Union who were marching to the capital with several demands, including farm loan waiver, crop insurance, support for small and marginal farmers, and implementation of the recommendations of the Swaminathan Commission report. Later in the day, the government assured that it will look into their demands by forming a committee of six chief ministers, but the protesters rejected it, saying they were not satisfied with the response. The Kisan Kranti Padyatra began from Tiket Ghat in Haridwar on 23rd of September and was to culminate today at Kisan Ghat, the memorial of farmer leader Chaudhary Charan Singh. Congress President Rahul Gandhi addressed a rally in Maharashtra's Wardha district on Tuesday, kicking off the party's programs for the 150th birth anniversary year of Mahatma Gandhi. At the rally, Gandhi accused Prime Minister Narendra Modi of dividing the country and making false promises. He also questioned the Prime Minister over the Rafael deal. The Congress is holding its working committee meeting in Wardha to mark the beginning of Mahatma Gandhi's 150th birth year celebrations. Earlier in the day, Rahul Gandhi offered prayers at Bapu Kutir at Sevagram Ashram, where Mahatma Gandhi stayed during his last years.
पूरी दुनिया में गिरते जा रहे हैं और हिंदुस्तान में पेट्रोल के दाम और महंगाई बढ़ती जा रही है एक के बाद एक हर रोज बढ़ता जा रहा है आपके जेब में से पैसा निकाला जा रहा है और हिंदुस्तान के 10-15 सबसे अमीर लोगों के जेब में डाला जा रहा है.
And now the news from Indonesia, where the number of people known to have died in Friday's earthquake and tsunami have risen to nearly 1,350. According to Indonesia's Disaster Response Agency, there are fears of some survivors still being trapped under the rubble of buildings. The 7.5 magnitude earthquake struck just off the central island of Sulawesi, setting off a tsunami that engulfed the coastal city of Palu. People there are growing increasingly desperate for food, fuel and water. Humanitarian relief convoys entering the city are now being escorted by soldiers and police. Meanwhile, Indian Navy has sent 3 warships to Indonesia for help. And for the first time in 55 years, a Nobel Prize in Physics has been awarded to a woman scientist. Dr. Donna Strickland from Canada is the third woman winner of the award after Marie Curie, who won in 1903, and Mary Goeppert Mayer, who was awarded the prize in 1963. Along with Dr. Strickland, Arthur Ashkin of the United States and Gerard Mourou of France won the Nobel Prize in Physics. At 96, Ashkin is the oldest person to win a Nobel Prize. The award recognizes the discoveries of 3 scientists in the field of laser physics. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. For more news and updates, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television. Namaskar.